Hello and welcome to the EMP Tech Group. Back out in the shop, with Jake. Got a fun project as always. And it's a printer stand. And it's like, oh my gosh, Dave, how many printer stand videos are you gonna do? But this one's interesting and different and got a lot going on. You know, we have a standard 4-inch wide printer stand where the shelves slide out, and we've got some great imagery of customers stacking those 4, 5, and 6 wide with a bunch of 4-inch wide label printers top and bottom, so they get a dozen printers in a pretty tight space and they can slide them out and change the media. But this customer had already built kind of a rougher version of this. By the way, it's red because that's the customer's color. It's red because the customer is a large retailer. It's not in their stores, it's in their backend operations. So that's where we work with retailers, is in their warehouses and distribution and back office, the back shop. So red because of the customer. This is a Fanfold tray that opens from the side. It's got a magnet on it. And the labels come out of this ZT411. The feed box is here in the back, and the label just come up in the back and then they fan fold into here. And then Jake, I mean, that's all good. You didn't build that part though, but you did this. The customer also wanted a counter, right?
Yeah, we added a counter to it, which we're doing some custom ZBI programming on the printer to take over one of the ports. And every time a label comes out, it outputs.
It increments a number there.
It increments up by one.
Yeah. I love that. Because, you know, hey, we did a custom printer stand. We kind of replicated what the customer had, but cleaned it up a little bit. And we also then used a feature in the printer that's just hardly ever known, that you can actually tie into. Are you on the, okay, so we had to get the applicator.
Yeah, we had an applicator
port. Yeah, again, you got to get an applicator port, and that is an option on this. Not on every Zebra printer, certainly not on the desktops, but the tabletops, the ZT411s, you can get this applicator port, which gives you some I/O capabilities with the printer, right?
Yep.
Yeah, so then, but it doesn't just natively work. Then you have to go in and with ZBI's, Zebra's basic interpreter, write a little application, which who wrote that?
Chad.
Chad wrote that, and so team effort here. So that application then is what tells the applicator port, what, every time you print one?
Yeah, it's actually looking at the media sensor in the printer, and it, every time it sees a label come through, it fires that output on the applicator.
And just a 24-volt signal? Okay, and then this display is just an off-the-shelf, and it recognizes that and counts automatically?
Yep.
So it's not like the printer's keeping track of the numbers and sending that out. It's just sending a pulse.
Yeah.
And then the counter that you put on here sees the pulse and increments one.
Yep. Yeah, okay. And then there's a reset button
that,
on it.
That so was my next question.
They come up and on grab the top. Your labels, they'll check the count, and then they'll reset it.
Okay, nice. Okay, so I printed a batch of labels. I got a Fanfold stack in here, a whole bunch of them. I can look at the counter and go, there's 1,000 in here. Yep. And then I hit the reset, tear it, take them, and then we can start another job on it. Cool. Well, that is fun. Again, shows off our outsource, but our fabrication capabilities. We've got a really good company here in Central Indiana with us that builds all these printer stands for us, that does the powder coating in-house and can custom colors. As you saw inside here, there's a little stainless base that helps hold and get the labels fan folded right. No sliding shelves on this, that's not needed. But then, and Jake, you did all the cat work for this too, right?
Yeah.
So you did have, we have to go in and take the customer sample, which is over behind the wall, and CAD draw it, send it to our manufacturer, and get them to replicate that for us, or really build our more improved version that you came up with. Yeah. Then ZBI on here, a little piece of hardware custom. It's got it all. So need a solution like this? Need a printer stand that's not our standard printer stand? We stock those. We got lots of those, but people come to us with these odd printer stand needs all the time. We're the guys, empTechGroup.com. Always the best place to reach us. Thanks for your time.